wanna see it like you see it.
Open the eyes of my heart.
So I wanna see you walk. Yeah, I wanna see your
eyes.
Come on, let's raise it real big. To see your
shining in the light of your glory. Uh-oh, I shouldn't have done that. Want to get the link for you.
Anybody want just to be in the... I want to see you. I want to see you. Come on, let's raise it. Say, open the come on, sing to Jesus today.
Open the eyes of my heart.
I want to see you like never before. You're what we want today. Come on, raise it again. Say, open the eyes.
Open the eyes of my heart, Lord.
I want to see it like you see
open
it.
Open the eyes of my heart.
So I want to see you, oh God. Yeah, I want to see your. Come on, let's raise it real big. To see your. Come on, shining in the light of your glory.
Shining in the light of your glory.
Father, we need you to pour today
pour
on every heart. As we see your. Hey, to see. Pour out your love, cause we want to see you. Yeah, yeah, yeah. We want to see you. If you want to see him, just lift those hands with us and say it again. Say, we want to see you. Hey, God. Somebody raise it.
We want to see you.
You're what we're looking for. You're what our heart longs for today, God.
We want to see you.
We need to see you. We want to see you.
We want to see you.
One more time, raise it. Say, open the eyes.
Open the eyes of my heart, Lord.
Say, open the eyes.
Open the eyes of my heart.
Tell them, I want to see you. You're all we want. You're all we need. Hallelujah. Say, open the eyes of my heart.
Open the eyes of my heart, Lord.
Say, open the eyes.
Open the eyes of my heart.
Say, God, fill us today, Jesus. Say, I want to see you. Oh, see you. Shining in the light of your glory. We need you to pour. This nation needs you to pour. God, we need you. We need you, Father. Come on, lift your voice to see. Are you ready? Everybody, put your hands.
Welcome,
you're what we're after
welcome
today.
Welcome
the
to
very
our
essence
hour,
of who
hour,
you are.
Worship. I hope
we
you
want
are
to see
expecting
you
to have a mighty move of God
we
on tonight.
We
I pray that you have invited
you
others
we
as well. Send out a text blast. Send out a Facebook blast. Get other people involved.
Lift those hands.
This
we
is inside, outside of our community. If seen a lot of things, but God, we need to see you in this season of our lives. Invite them, invite them.
We want to see you. Everything in my life, God, we want.
We want to see you.
Everything in my life. Everything in my life, God,
we want to see you.
If you want to see him, lift those hands and everybody just praise him. Let the glory of the Lord hit your house. Let the glory of the Lord hit your car. Let the glory of the Lord hit your living room. We're asking for you, God. You said if we seek, we'll find you. If we knock, you'll open the door. Because we want to see you. We want to see you. We need you, God. We want to see you. Show yourself strong. Arise, oh God, and let your enemies be scattered. Because we want to see you. Lift those hands wherever you are. You're all we want. You're all we need. God, you're all we want. You're all we need. Yeah. You're all we want. You're all we need. God, you're all we want. You're all we need. You're all we want. God, you're all we need. That's why we're looking for you today. Because we've looked for other things and they left us empty, God. We've looked for other people and they disappointed us, God. But today we pursue your presence because you're all we want and you're all we need. See, you're all we want. Come on. I need you to, you're all we need.
Welcome, 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 welcome to our power hour of worship. And I want to probably tell you, welcome to the first of many of our power hour of worship. Amen, amen, amen. I want to let you know to expect a powerful move of God. I want to let you know that God is going to move according to your faith, according to your engagement, according to how much you're able, you're willing to open up, and how much you're willing to receive him on today. And so today, I know that some of us have some dark situations that we may find ourselves in. Some of us may have some things that we're going through, and that's the purpose of why we're here today, not to ignore these different things, but to say, Lord, we come into you, and we ask, and for these chains to be broken. Lord, we asking for deliverance from these different things. And we're standing here in agreement with our sisters, with our brothers, and we're expecting to see you move in a mighty way, Father. We know that when we ask and not ask of amiss, that you will move, Father. And so we're believing that things are going to move in the unseen arena. Now, we may not see it manifest on tonight, but we know for a fact that you're going to move on today, and that we're going to see it come through and manifest when we believe inside of our hearts. So your expectation, how you engage, how you believe, and how you receive is going to determine what you receive on today. All right. And so we're going to open up in prayer, and I'm going to turn it into my mother in Christ, Miss Joyce, to open us up in prayer. Miss Joyce. Amen.
Good evening, brothers and sisters. Welcome, welcome, welcome. Let us go to the throne of grace. Father God, we come tonight, Lord, just to lift you up high. Father, we don't come for form or fashion, but we come to just worship and to praise you and to love on you because you are worthy to be praised. Father, open our eyes that we may see Father, we come bowing down before you. Father, we come just bringing everything as an empty pitcher to be filled with your glory. Father, just let your Shekinah glory just fall all in this Zoom tonight on each home, on each person. Let us see you. We say yes, yes, Lord, to your will. Father, we render this service to you in the mighty name of Jesus, and the sweet Holy Spirit, set it on fire for your glory. In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray. Amen.
Amen, amen, amen. Beautiful. And so the first thing that we're going to do is we're going to start to worship. We are going to worship on today. We are leaning on Acts 16, and we are going to start off with worship. I'm going to also give you the opportunity to engage in worship and unmute if you have the environment that is inducive of being able to welcome the Holy Spirit. You can unmute and we can see.
There is power.
Yeah.
So when are we going to have a meeting?
Yes,
Lord. There is power. In the name of Jesus,
I pray you can sing.
There is power in the name of Jesus. Come on, break every chain, break every chain, break every chain.
Yes, Lord.
Break every chain, break every chain. Break every chain. Let's say it together. There is power. There is power in the name of Jesus. You got it. There is power in the name of Jesus.
Hold your power.
Your power.
There is power in the name of Jesus. To break every chain. Now somebody lift your hands in the air right here. Say there's an army.
Yeah.
Keep silent. Say there's an army.
Yeah.
There's an army, there's an army rising up. Now shut it up, say to break every chain, to break every chain, break every chain.
That beauty and you want to be on the hands, right hand, right gesture. Thank you, Father.
Break.
Yes.
Yes. Yes.
Yes.
Yes. Depression. That's an anxiety. That's the molestation. It doesn't matter what it is. Break in Jesus'
break
name.
Yes.
Yes.
Change. Something about being able to sing, even when you're going through your pain, even when you've been able to go through it. And that takes us over to our book of Acts 16 and 26. I'm not your minister on today or your host. We have our sister minister, Denise, that's going to minister on for us for today. But I want to read it for today, and let me put it inside of the chat box so that we all have it. I'm going to jump down to, it's Acts 16 and 40 is the entire thing, but I'm going to jump down. I'm going to first tell you at the beginning of this story, it was Paul and Silas, and there was a young lady who was a slave that was following Paul and Silas around, and she had a demon spirit inside of her, and she was following them around and taunting them, kind of sort of saying, they gonna take you, they're serving the Almighty, and they're gonna tell you how to be saved. And she did this for some days, and after a while Paul got tired of her doing this. And so she cast, now I forgot to tell you beforehand, she was a fortune teller. And by her telling fortunes, she made her owner's money. And after so many days of following Paul around, Paul got tired of her doing that. And Paul rebuked the spirit and cast it out of her. And now she no longer made her owners any money. And so the owners became upset with Paul, and put Paul and Silas in prison. Okay, so this is where we are now. Paul and Silas is in prison, and I'm going to read. This is Acts 16, and I'm picking up at 25. I'm picking up where Paul and Silas is in a dark place. Okay, around midnight, Paul and Silas were praying, they're in prison, okay? We're praying and singing hymns to God, and the other prisoners were listening. Suddenly, there was a massive earthquake, and the prison was shaken to the foundation. All the doors immediately flew open, and the chains of every prisoner fell off. The jailer woke up to see the prison doors wide open. He assumed the prisoners had escaped, so he drew his sword to kill himself. But Paul shouted to him, "Stop, don't kill yourself. We are all here." The jailer called for lights and ran to the dungeon and fell down trembling before Paul and Silas. Then he brought them out and asked, "Sir, what must I do to be saved?" They replied, "Believe in the Lord Jesus and you will be saved, along with everyone in your household." And they shared the word of the Lord with him and with all who lived in the household. Even at the hour of the night, the jailer cared for them and washed their wounds. Then he and everyone in his household were immediately baptized. He brought them into his house and set a meal before them. And he and his entire household rejoiced because they all believed in God. The next morning, the city officials sent the police to tell the jailer, "Let the men go." So the jailer told Paul, "The city officials have said you, Silas, are free to leave. Go in peace." And I'm going to turn it over to our sister minister, Denise, to take it from here.
God bless you. Praise the Lord. We thank you for the reading of God's already blessed word. We thank our sister Clarissa for that scripture. And we are just going to move on in the word. She gave you a little bit of background, but I want to go just a little bit further. But sometimes some of the things that we need to go back to need to let us know we're not the only ones that sin fall short of God's glory, but deliverance. Hallelujah. How many thank him for deliverance? Hallelujah. So when we look in this scripture, if we go back before Paul was Paul, Paul was Saul. And when we come over to the Lord's side, he needs to change our name. Now, he might not exactly change Denise from Denise Singletary or Denise Singletary Dudley, but he needs to change the characteristics and the countenance of that name, because there's a lot of things that are attached to that name that were not so sweet and were not so lovely. But in the beginning, Paul was Saul first, and Saul was an accuser of the brethren. In other words, he persecuted the believers. He was almost like the terrorists that we deal with now in America. He was like an assassinator. He would kill you immediately if you had anything to do with Christianity. But one day, Paul was traveling the road of Damascus, and he had his own personal encounter with the Lord. And that's why Paul is no longer Saul. He's now Paul, because he had his own personal encounter. And during that time, he became blind. He was blind and had to have people leading him around. And the Lord asked Ananias in the Bible to bless him and to touch him and to lay hands. But Ananias in the Bible had wanted nothing to do with Paul, Saul, because everyone knew he was mean, he was nasty, he was an assassinator. And let's be honest, those are not people that we really want to have a one-on-one direction with. But beside what Ananias felt, he listened to what Jesus Christ instructed and laid hands on Saul, and Saul regained his sight. But how many of us know sometimes God has to put us in a blinded state so that we can't see everything around us? We can't see what we used to do, but we can now walk into the new light that God has now. He has now saw God in a new light. So he was able to regain his sight. And Paul and Silas took Paul along with him as they were traveling through worshiping and telling of the goodness of Jesus and all that he had done. And as our sister mentioned, they came across a woman who was demonically possessed. And like she said, the men in the town used her as a fortune teller. They were making money off of her. And even though the enemy knows who God is, he'll still use somebody that he feels that he has an attack over their mind to antagonize and to try to downgrade who God is. And finally, like she said, they said, "Listen, this is it. Now, we command this demon to come out." The demon came out. The town, they lied on them and said, "Oh, they're doing," in other words, they were trying to act like they were doing the witchcraft and they were doing the evil thing. And so they ordered them to be thrown into jail, and they whipped them and they antagonized them and they brutalized them, all in the name of Jesus. And I know I am not the only sister on this line that we be getting whipped, slapped, kicked, tormented in Christ just for saying that we trust God, just for saying that we believe in the Father and the Son and the Holy Ghost, just believe that we are going to stay on the road of Christ and in alignment with Christ by our choice of being in a relationship with God. So we thank God that even in the midst of what they went through, they didn't bow down, they didn't change their story, they went all the way. And as she said, when the time came, when midnight came, they were still worshiping their God. They were still praising their God. Nothing that was done to them caused them to curse God and walk away. And they told him, take him into intercourse. They done said, see, now you taking me deep, deep. You want to make sure I don't get out. You want to take me in the middle. And they said, get your strongest chains and take him in the darkest area. But how many know sometimes it's like late in the midnight hour we sing that song? When it's at that last hour and we have done and said all that we think we can physically can do, and when we tap into that spirit, y'all know those songs that our ancestors sung. Come on, they were slaves in the field, but they were singing worship songs unto the Lord because they knew one day, somehow, the God that they were serving, change was going to come. And that was how it was for Paul and Silas in the prison. They still worship. They still sing. They said, no, we're not going to feel sorry for ourselves because we're being persecuted for Christ's namesake. And when you give God a yes, you got to go all the way. We can't be in a situation where we sing, for Christ I live and for Christ we die. Now, we know we say it as a cliche, but if we're in a room and somebody say, those that are followers of Christ can live and those that are not, we're going to take out. How many of us are going to still say yes? How many of us are going to be like them Hebrews in the fiery furnace, and we still gonna keep on going because we gonna know we gonna come out of this. We don't know when and we don't know how, but we stand flat footed on the word of God that never changes and let us know you will survive this. So sisters, whatever it is you're going through, whatever you have been through, whatever took place when you was 5, 10, 15, 20, whatever took place when you was 40 or 50, know that you are on the winning team. Know that in the end, you shall win. And we know that God is going to come see about his people. That's one thing about God. He's not going to put us in a situation that he's not able to do exceedingly and abundantly above all we ask and thinking or want. So when that time came, he sent an angel. There was an earthquake. The angel shook the jail. The angel shook and all the chains came open. Nobody understood what was going around. And I'm sure, I guess they call him, we call him a CO, a correction officer. He was ready to pull his sword and take his own life. Why? How am I going to explain to the people that everybody gone, that everybody got out? And he also thought, look, they coming to get me because I know what I did. And whether or not they were guilty, discharged or not, I followed the instructions. So he was like, I'd rather cut my own neck off, cut my own head off and die. And then what did Paul do? He yelled, this thing, really, he was telling him, this ain't even got nothing to do with you. This is bigger than you. So he said, wait a minute. If this is bigger than me and I know I didn't let them out, I know they got to be attached to a higher power, a higher being than me, because I didn't do anything. And the people that told me to put him in jail probably in their beds. So who did it? God did it. Just like in our situations, don't you worry. I don't care if you in the bottom of the pit like Joseph. I don't care if you're in the fiery furnace like the Hebrew boys. You better know that your father reigns. You better know he's the greatest power and beside him no other, there is no other. And you better know that you can make it through the situation. See, we came together thinking we was talking about just weight loss. This is bigger than weight loss. This is an anointed, God-ordained sisterhood of powerful women. God has a thought and a plan for every single one of you. Why do you think we go through so many attacks? Because we're doing something right. If we are on the Lord's side and we are walking according to his commandments and his covenant and his alignment and thought and plan, you better know if he's not bothering you, then I would be worried. Because that means you ain't doing that much to antagonize him. You're not doing that much to make him think that you're a threat. When we wake up in the morning, not he hit the floor. Oh, she got up again. I thought I had last night with the last thing. Pierce was cutting up. I thought she was going to throw in the towel then. Oh, they bother her at the job. They just picking on her for no reason. Just because she walking around, good morning, praise the Lord, and got a light of God on her life. We're marked. We're marked for greatness, but the adversary also mocks us when people are of a demonic spirit and they're following their father, the devil. They have a problem with you. Oh, I just don't like her. What? Oh, something about her. Yes, it's the light of Jesus that you always see. So come on over to the Lord's side. Maybe if we're doing everything that we need to do, they'll see something in us to say, you know what? Michelle ain't really do nothing to me. So why am I really, I'm kind of wondering why. I know she had a situation at home last night, but she's still coming in here smiling. Let me learn. Let me want to learn a little something about Jesus that she speaks so well of. And then we got to keep in mind, some people are taught from their youth, whatever denomination they're going to be in ministry. Some of them don't know our way. They think that their way is right. That's why God tells us don't debate religion. But if we let them see our light and they see the light of God in us and they see something different, we'll be, you know, when we're in kingdom, we're set apart. We're different. There's something different. Even if you know somebody want to accuse you of something that's not true, I don't know. I'm not getting that from her. That's not how she carried herself. You know what I mean? So with Paul and Silas, the Lord set them free. Why? Because they worship through the storm. They didn't do anything wrong. There are many stories. Jesus Christ didn't do anything wrong. He died an ignominious death, a death where he did no wrong. They much rather put him between a murderer and a robber and take him all the way and brutally beat him and whip him. And he could have come down from the cross to save himself. He's the Son of God. He could have, but he decided to die to save wretches like you and I. He decided to die to give us a right to the tree of life. He decided to die because he knew we were going to be living in a dying world and we needed a savior. We needed a sacrifice. And he chose to go all the way. So with Paul and Silas, they got what they knew he was coming. You see about them. And it's just like in your current situation. One thing I know is they say one thing for sure and two things for certain. I don't know when he's coming, but I know he will. And then I look back over some of my situations and it was like, I didn't know when he was coming. I don't even know when he came, but I know I'm out. I know I'm delivered. I know I'm still here 17 years later from a cancer diagnosis. I had no control over whether or not I was going to be looking at y'all pretty faces tonight or y'all was going to be looking at mine. But guess what? Next month, 17 years later, after a diagnosis, oh, it's going to kill you. Oh, we got to operate. Oh, we got, and I did none of the above, fasting and praying. It's something about when you come into alignment and covenant with our God. He's going to see you through. Now, yes, we do have to go through some things for our fruits to teach us long suffering, to teach us patience. Because if we didn't go through nothing, how are you going to tell the next sister or brother anything about what the Lord can do? And if we didn't need them, him, good God Almighty, we would not all be on this line tonight. We came here in expectation. And I pray that you receive what you need. I pray that you build your relationship with the God, with God. Talk to him in prayer. Sometimes we want to talk to our friends and our sisters or our spouses. They have no power. Take it to the rock that is higher than we are. We see many stories in the Bible. All of Joseph's brother threw him in a pit. Why? Because they thought it was the power was in the coat. He was the anointed vessel, not the coat. But people are so really Cain and Abel, brothers slaying brothers. Why? Because you think you're getting the power. You tricked your daddy and made him think that you was the one. You weren't the chosen one. But don't you know we are the chosen vessels of God? Don't you know somebody wished they had the life that you had? Somebody wished they had the relationship? We are all sinners saved by grace. We are not a perfect people, but God knows we serve a perfect God. And he every day he gives us new grace and new mercy. So just to leave us with a few thoughts. One, based on y'all hearing the story of Saul and Paul, straight up murderer. That means God can use anybody he wants. So please, your children, your mates, your family members, whomever is not saved or that you're praying for that have backslidden, they may even fall short of God's glory today. Know that God can save and use anybody he chooses. Amen. Number two, the reason that Saul was able to switch over to Paul, that was because of God's grace. God did that. Can't nobody save you, can't nobody deliver you, can't nobody change you, but God, the Father Almighty. And when you come in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost, the Trinity. Amen. They're all one, but we know the part, the intricate parts that they play. Amen. Again, Saul was compared to a terrorist. We know terrorists flew into that World Trade Center. No regard for human life. If they thought you was a Christian, you was getting, as they say in the world, you was getting God. But look how God turned his heart. When you give your heart to God, just like with the warden or the CO, as we call them, he was immediately ready. I don't know who these brothers belong to. I don't know who they serve, but give me a piece of that one. Jump me in. Immediately, he knew there was something different about the event that happened. You don't just go in no jail and no earthquake just come out of here. Okay, they do come. A lot of people die, things crumble, but guess what? Those chains were literally broken. No more bondage. Come on, sisters. No more bondage, no more captivity. And don't you throw yourself back in handcuffs that's not even there no more. If God has forgiven you, first we got to repent. If you've repented of anything, I don't care. I might have had my child when I was 15. I might have had abortion when I was 17. I might, whatever. When you ask God to forgive you, you then forgive yourself. And don't you go back to it. And don't you let anybody put you in bondage. We are free. We heard the chains falling during the worship. We heard the doors opening. We heard the hurt that we holding in our heart be released. We seen God deliver us. So don't you dare put yourself back in bondage. I know we are, you know, fab work sisters, and we're designed to get rid of this dead weight, and we're going to get rid of the dead weight. Trust me. Just stay the course. I don't care if you walk 10,000 steps today and 200 the next day. Keep it moving. Don't go back. Don't be like a dog that go back to his old vomit, or a dog that's had a cookout and a hot piece of meat fell on the ground and he gonna keep trying to pick it up and eat and he burned his mouth up. We are going to stay the course, ladies, 2022, all the way. No excuses. If you miss one day, get up the next day. We got 31 days. We got time to get back on it. Matter of fact, forget 31 days. We got a lifetime. This is a lifestyle change. This ain't just we going to do it today because, you know, we in a competition and we trying to, we for real about this time. Come on here. Just like our salvation. We know we're living today. That we know we're going to leave here one day and we are going, we expecting to make heaven our home. We are going to keep moving. We are a sisterhood. Five is 10. One move, all move. Nobody left behind. It's just like the firemen when they run into a fire. They don't plan to leave nobody in the parish. Their goal is to save everybody. So we linked up. We linked up. That's the only chain we got going on. We linked up arm to arm, sister to sister. And we're pulling each other through. We bless God for this group, for the encouragement, and for the different things. And we just got to be reminded that only God can save you. I don't care what nobody say. People try to antagonize you. Oh, yeah, you trying this again. Oh, you had that again. Oh, yeah, you're going to lose 50 pounds and gain 100. Just like they did with the woman who was demon-possessed, you can speak to us. I rebuke that. I rebuke that conversation. We bind up all negativity in Jesus' name. Success is my portion. I can quote your scriptures. I can do all things through Christ who strengthened me. My God, through me, through my push, he can do exceedingly and abundantly above all I can ask, think, or want. What you think is what you get. Our tongue has power. Power of life and death lies in the tongue. Niecy, you're going to get this weight off, girl. You're going to get down. What size you want? Okay. Talk to yourself. We bind up somebody thinking you got a lunatic spirit. No, I'm talking in my atmosphere. You got to set your atmosphere. Just like they said, you know what? We don't had enough of this antagonizing spirit through this person that we know is demon possessed. Let me rebuke you and get you on out the way so I can live my life, so we can go on and do what the Father told us to do and finish our assignment. This year, 2022, we are finishing our assignments. Forgive yourself. Forget it. Let them go. Let him go. Let her go. Let them go. Anybody that's in the way of what you're doing, give them the gift of goodbye. How about that? God bless you. You can still keep praying, but you don't have to subject yourself. See, that's the problem. Some of us, we're fighting a fight that's not even ours. We're not equipped to carry the weight. We're not equipped all we can do is speak a thing. Give it to the Lord. Cast it upon the Lord. Lay it at the altar. That's his assignment. We can't carry it. That's why we're overwhelmed. That's why we're overworked. That's why we're so broken. But tonight, I say live. Tonight, I say get up and live and stay up and live. I say look to the hills from which coming to help. I say the devil is a liar. I know I'm not the only one today because we came in great expectation that went through warfare. I'm sniffling at the job. I'm coughing, my voice going in and out. I didn't care if I can be like Kermit the Frog or Barry White. Either one. Y'all was going to get either one. Y'all know I'm a girl. Y'all know I'm a lady. But see, he tried any way he can. I got the box of tissue. I got the this and that. But guess what? We are here and we are going all the way. Because whenever attacks come, you better know the Holy Ghost got something to say. And I just thank the Lord for the time today. I thank him for an opportunity to use. I thank him for being his mouthpiece. I thank him for being his prayer warrior. Nothing so great that I did. He saw something good in this little whatever color hair I got tonight, girl, that he wanted to use me. He wants to use you. Don't ever think that your situations, I don't care what you've been through, let your story be unto his glory. Everything that we went through in our lives has everything to do with where we're going. So let your voice be heard. Tell your testimony. Tell of his goodness. Talk about this group. Bring them sisters in. There's so many hurting people out there that feel like they're so lost. We are here. And one thing about me, anybody who knows me, family and friends, I don't play around with. I take that very serious. I got friends that I've been friends with 30 and 40 years. They say, you stay in contact with everybody. You're supposed to. You're supposed to first show yourself friendly so you can gain some friends. And y'all not only my friends, y'all my sisters. And I'm grateful. I'm grateful for your life. I thank God for your destiny. And we are going to make it. If you got an issue, pick that phone up. Get on that thread. Ask for prayer. Don't be ashamed of anything but of not asking. So we just love you with the love of the Lord. And we pray that the Lord continues to bless this line until we dismiss on tonight. And I'm so grateful that there's more coming. There's more coming. So get ready, sisters. There's more nights like this that are coming in Jesus' name. Amen. God bless. Thank you. Thank you, God.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Hallelujah. Amen.
And
hallelujah.
So, thank you so thank you, much, God. Sister. Amen. Thank you, God. Amen. Sister. So who is ready to win? Who is ready to claim their victory? Who has said, yes, I know that this is coming up? Who is said, like the verse first, the first verse it says that they were inside the prison cell and they said it was at midnight. But you can look at midnight one way and you can look at midnight one way. So to some, midnight is darkness and to some, midnight is the morning. And so morning marks a new day. And so who is ready to say, today is my new day? I'm going through some things, but I know that I serve a God that will turn my pain into joy. I know a God that will take the things that I go through and he's going to make me victorious in the things that I go through. So who's ready to celebrate? Who's ready to say, yes, Rissa, I'm going through some things. Yes, Rissa, I have some pain on the inside, but however, I know that the God that I serve, that I still can praise him as I'm going through this thing. I'm not blind to the fact that I'm going through some stuff. I'm not blind to the fact that I'm trying to fix the marriage. I'm not blind through the fact that I got the kids that's going through the things. But however, I remember how my God saved me through the last thing that I was going through. I remember how my God pulled me out from the last thing. So because of what he helped me with on the last thing, I can rejoice on today. What sisters, what brothers do I have that's on this Zoom that's on today that can say, Rissa, I can praise him and what I'm going through on today? Who's ready to win on tonight? Because I'm ready to win on tonight. I'm ready to win on tonight. I'll give you an opportunity to unmute and, and usher in the spirit. And
put your tails on just dancing, right?
Glory, glory, glory.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Anybody have a winning season? Anybody have a winning season? Jesus, Jesus, Jesus.
My winning
Everything attached to me wins. Everything attached to me wins. Everything attached to me wins. That means my children win. That means my family wins. Thank you, Jesus. That means I'm successful on the job, Jesus. That means I'm successful in the business. Thank you, Jesus. That means I'm successful on this weight loss journey. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. That means the health condition that it doesn't look like I'm going to get past. Thank you, Jesus. I thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. That means the marriage that doesn't look like it's going to get fixed. It's going to get fixed. I thank you, Jesus. I thank you, Jesus. It's my winning season. I thank you, Jesus. I thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. I thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Everything attached to me wins. Everything attached to me wins. Everything, everything, everything. Thank you, Father. Everything, Father. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Father. May not look like I'm winning right now. The enemy may have probably knocked me down for a minute, but it's my winning season. I will win. I have won. I'm moving in the unseen arena, even when I don't understand it. I thank you, Father. I thank you, Father. I thank you, Father. You're such an awesome God. You're such a mighty God. There's nothing I go do like this. Thank you, Jesus. I thank you, Jesus.
Yeah, and then the
Yeah, then you have. I call you broken. I don't call you broken. I call you defeated.
I am a champion. You are a champion. Amen. 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 Yes. There is a God that will take my setback concerning it and put my step up. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Yes, Lord. It's my winning season. Yes, Lord. Somebody give God praise right there. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father.
I can't see you physically, but I just know that as you give God praise,
the louder your clap, the louder your praise, the louder your victory. Let the enemy know that he has been defeated. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Oh, thank you, Lord. Thank you. Thank you, Father. Zach the lame man, do you want to get up? If you want it, you can have it. Amen. Who want it? Amen. Who wants this thing called better health? Amen. Who wants this thing called walking with freedom, no joint pain? Amen. Who wants their marriage healed? Amen. Who wants their children on the right path? Amen. Who want a close relationship with God? Amen. Hallelujah, Sadai, Hallelujah, Sadai. Jesus is yours. Who want it? Amen.
Hallelujah.
You want it? Amen.
Your will be done.
In the name of Jesus. Something about that name, Jesus. You call on the name Jesus. Jesus. Jesus, Jesus. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. For you thought it was no other way. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. When your back was up against the wall. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. And in late night hour when you can't help but to cry. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. 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 When there's no other word. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Hallelujah. Jesus, Jesus, Amen. You would never be the same. Jesus. Jesus, 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 Jesus. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Ha! Never fell. Never lost a fight. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Nothing caught him by surprise. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Hallelujah. Amen. 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 What's his name? Jesus.
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 Amen.
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 Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. I am going to turn it over to Miss Joyce to close us out in prayer. I pray to God that you felt a mighty move of Jesus, of God, inside of your home. I pray to God that you received him. I pray to God that you believe in your heart that whatever it is that you was believing to receive on today, that you have received it, and that you know that things are moving in the unseen arena on your behalf, that whatever it is that you are going through, that it has not caught God by surprise, and that there is nothing that you are going through that is too big that God is not in control of, and that, like our brother before us, Paul, that we're not just asking for an escape, and soon as the door is open, we're running out, but we're asking God to give us the endurance as we go through these things, because we know that as we go through these things, that God is going to give us the strength to be the light for others around us. Some of us got family members members that's counting on us to be able to make it out of these prison doors, these different things that we're enslaved to, these different things that we're in bondage to. They're counting on us to not run out and escape, but to be delivered from these different things. And so I pray to God that that your spirit was touched and that your spirit was blessed and that you hold tight to this and that you do not let the enemy creep in, because you best believe, as much as you clapping and you stumping and you praying, that the enemy hears and that he's going to try to talk some stuff inside your ears, and we're going to say, shut your mouth, devil. My God said, I am victorious. My God said, I am the head and not the tail. My God said, I am above and not beneath. My God said that I have victory. My God said that he fights on my behalf. My God said, the battle is not mine. My God said, he got me. In all other words, he got me. And so when he comes up against what, no matter what it is that we're going through, we all have a story. And I did this right here because when you sisters sent in your prayer requests, we got some stuff that we're facing. And none of it caught God by surprise. None of it's in vain, you know. And it's all able to be fixed on, and much of it is being fixed on already, but we got to hang on to that faith. And while we're walking through this pain, we got to hold our head high. Again, at 515 pounds, this is the biggest testimony that I can hold on to, so y'all gonna hear it from then on out. At 515 pounds, I would have never thought that God was going to use this to be my story to tell. The enemy thought that he had me in my grave, and I thought he did too. The enemy thought that was the end of my life. He thought he ruined my relationship with my children. He thought he had me where no man was going to want me. He thought he had me where my friends was going to make fun of me and didn't really want to be real friends to me. He thought I was going to have to be in a chair every time I went around. He thought I was going to be a WMUT by the time I was 50 and that I wasn't going to be able to move and do about. But God took all of that. He took all of that and helped me to be able to be able to give back to others, to be able to have a new, like, he took all of that pain and turned it into this right here. So the different situations that each of us is facing is not in vain, is not unnoticed, and it's not permanent. Amen. I'm going to turn it over to you, Ms. Joyce.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Only thing we can say is praise the Lord and thank you, Jesus, and the sweet Holy Spirit, because you sure have manifest yourself this night. Father God, we come just now just to say thank you, thank you, thank you for expressing your love and showing up on this Zoom tonight. Father, I speak to each one of us. Let us not leave this meeting the same. Let us not pick it up, but Father, we just love you and we just thank you and we magnify your name. There's nothing else to be said because everything has been said and we have worshiped you. So I just thank you and I praise you and I declare and decree that everything that the sisters have prayed for and asked for, that it will be done in your name. So we say good night to you, Father. And that we love you in the mighty name of Jesus and the sweet Holy Spirit. Amen.
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 Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you.
Amen.
Amen.
Victory, ladies. Walk in victory.
Beautiful service. Amen.
Have a good night. Good night.
Good night.
Remember that you are
Glory.
What a powerful move of God.
Yes. Glory. Thank you to all of our guests. Thank you. Thank you. Hallelujah. Praise God. Praise God for you.
Mute, Clarissa.
And to the men on the line, thank you for the men that joined us on the line. Yes.
Excuse me, my brothers, gentlemen.
Amen. Amen. Love you all and have a good night.
Love you.
Love you all. Good night. Love you.
Good night.
Good night.
Good night. Come on, Tony.